Ammo is crazy expensive and hard to find, and dry fire is life. I use the Mantis X10 to keep my handgun skills strong, and it makes dry practice fun and challenging. Check it out at the link below.
Hey everybody, Brian Hill from the Complete Combatant, and this is your Mantis Dry Fire Monday, brought to you by Active Self-Protection Extra. I did it. Didn't get tied up over that, so that's good. It means we're going to have a good lesson today. I'm going to talk to you guys about a cognitive term you may not be familiar with. It's something that's used in athletics a lot, and it's called touch mapping. The idea that our hands are incredible sensors of what's going on around us and how we can feel how things are moving is really important. I find with shooters, though, they always think about pressure this way or pressure this way, and they get what we call touch hot spots, where they're putting so much pressure in it. The inverse of that means that there's empty spots in their grip. So if you make your hand very rigid, we call this a dead hand, which means the palm is kind of open in there. And as a mixed martial arts coach and a jiu-jitsu coach, I know this is the easiest escape. If the hand is rigid, it's much easier to get away from. Gripping human beings that are fighting you and sweaty is a good way to learn how to grip things properly. So we're going to apply that to our firearms grip now. If we're using our Mantis, we're going to see this show up because we're not going to have good connection to the gun. Remember, you're not holding the gun still with your hands. You're holding the gun still with your posture. Okay? Your hands are holding the gun relative to you so that you can apply proper pressure with the trigger, and you can also apply proper posture. So what is this grip mapping stuff? Well, we're going to need a firearm. So let me get this out. Let's clear it for everybody. Make sure it's okay. All right. No magazine. Physically and visually verify it. Let you guys check it out. We're good to go. Okay. All right. So I'm going to make the best grip I can with my primary hand. And what I'm going to do is I'm really going to feel this pinky and this ring finger, because they're going to do the majority of gripping. The index finger is helping tremendously. Of course, the index does no gripping, and the thumb is completely out of position to grip unless I put it down here. But if I'm going to build a two-handed grip, it'll either be in a way, creating a wedge right here that leaves space. So I need to move it out of the way so my other palm can fill that space and connect the grip and make a total encirclement of the gun. As wide as this gun is, I really don't have much thenar pressure. I have a bit. I can influence the gun a bit, but it's not very strong, okay? So it's gonna be these bottom three fingers are doing the grip. A good way to do this is kind of close your eyes and feel. Now I can feel there's a little bit of pocket opening, and the back strap of the gun is not really around. There it is, it's on my thenar now. Now I feel pressure equally through the hand. Now I'm gonna squeeze too hard. See what happens to the gun, it begins to shake. And if it's too light, I don't have any real connection. Anything happened, it would fly away from me. So I want to be somewhere in between that. Now, I'm going to grip as hard as I can and then just relax. Okay, now I'm connected to the gun. It doesn't have to be stiff and rigid. We don't want a dead hand. Now I'm going to bring the other hand in, and I'm going to find my middle finger, and I'm going to make an index to that, and I'm going to wrap my palm in here. So I'm rolling these together, and then my palm comes in and does that. Now I want to think about this pinky, this ring finger, this middle finger, and this index finger, and see how they're relating. I have pretty big hands, so it's really hard for me to get pinky pressure in there. So my index finger is just slightly out of position and away from that, so that I have a bit more space. Okay, one of the reasons I like bigger guns is because I got big hands. Now, when I grip it, what I want to do is see, is there any space in there? You guys look, you won't see any space really in that position. Okay, now my grip is in there. Okay, I'm going to point the gun at you because we're going to watch the muzzle. Right. Now, if I've done all this correctly, the next thing I need to touch map is how my finger relates to the trigger. If I put too much finger on the right side of the trigger for a right-handed shooter, it will move the gun left. Did you guys see that? Boom, it just moved left. If I put my finger too deep in there and I tend to pull to the right, it will move the gun to the right. And you guys can clearly see that in the muzzle. But if I take my finger and let it rest across the entire face of the trigger, feel all aspects of the trigger with a relaxed finger, I can make it a steering wheel, like in a car. I can feel feedback from the road. I'm gonna feel the feedback as I'm moving through the trigger here, and that tells me whether my finger is firmly pressing the trigger straight back. If it's to one side or another, and I'll feel it pressing away, it gives me another feedback sensation to make a better shot. So I'm going to relax the finger and let it wrap around, okay? Now I got a pretty good feel with the trigger. I've touch mapped my hands, okay? And now I'm just gonna try to move it straight back. All right, now I saw a little lift, so I'm gonna add a little pinky pressure. And that fixed it. and then the dot has taught me exactly what I need to know. That's the idea of touch mapping. Some of us are really visually driven, and we will override all sensory inputs from the other senses to just see more. And that's not a bad way to go, but why not use both? Don't pick one or the other. There's a constant argument. It's either this or that. But the world is full of compromises. And if I could feel how the gun is moving in my hand and I can see it in the sights, then I'm a better shooter. If I only see it and I don't know what's making it happen, it's hard to correct. And if I only feel it, I'm not really sure where it's pointed. So these two systems have to work together. You've got to map the touch of how you're connected to the gun. You have to be able to press the trigger and feel the full face of the trigger on both sides, especially with Glocks. It's easy to get right side or left side trigger heavy, and then press it straight to the rear, and the sights will tell me if I've mapped my touch according to the gun and it's well connected. Too much tension is bad, too little tension is bad. Let's find that Goldilocks zone where we have good feeling of what we're doing, really connected with a loose, pliable, well, maybe loose is not the word, sorry. Let's try a different word. We're gonna say a pliable hand that is relaxed a little bit more, all right? This death grip is no good. In jiu-jitsu, we know it's easy to get away from somebody squeezing really hard because it makes the hand rigid. So keep the hand pliable. I hope that helps you out a lot, guys. And as always, I really appreciate y'all. I just got back from 3 sold-out days in Texas, and now I'm off to California to teach. And I wanted to spend a little bit of time with you guys before I left. And the feedback from lessons has been fantastic. I'm honored, and you guys have my respect and admiration for doing the work. Because skill is born of struggle, and you need to practice enough where it feels like you're struggling through things that you're questioning and you're improving all the time. Look for every edge. Don't just do what you think is right. Look for another edge. Find another way to do it better than you would before. Very seldom is it gear, but in this case, it is your gear. You're going to use your cognitive and your neurological system to make you better gear in the long run. Make sure you subscribe. Hit the like button. This is Active Self-Protection Extra, and thank you to Mantis. Mantis has a great way for you to map this because you're going to be able to see the difference. If you try several different grips and then go back and look at your grip map, remember which each one is, you'll see a difference in the way you're pressing the trigger. Touch mapping is a very important term, and I haven't really heard anybody in firearms talk about it, so I wanted to spend a little bit of time with you guys. All right, as always, measure, refine, and perform.